Welcome to Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the biggest entertainment stories and definitely analyze them for you. My name is Elsie Godwin, and I'm here with my very energetic co-anchors, Ife Omai and Benny Ack.
Can you just give me a conference? Get happy.
Like, very energetic. Like,
yeah, you too.
I'm shutting down. Like.
Why are you shutting down?
I don't know, man. I just feel my mind has been working like 24 hours already, but hey, it's all good.
It's all right.
Okay.
We're almost there.
Yeah, almost there, right? to like 8:30.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Okay. Let's start with Blac Chyna. He claims, she claims, that name Chyna sounds, you know, but yeah. She claims Rob Kardashian is unfit parent because he's too afraid to leave the house. She also cites her ex-fiance's alleged mental health issue and his past suicidal tendencies in response to his lawsuit seeking to gain primary custody of their daughter, Trim. Okay, I don't think I'm even surprised I'm going to fault her for doing this because he started it.
Yeah.
And they went low and she went lower, you know, so I think she's playing the card the way I would play it if I were in her shoes.
Yeah. I remember we talked about this before. The first time I came and said, you know, they're against Black culture and maybe that's why. But when the topic came out, there was a lot more information that has now been coming out and the lawyers are using more of their real examples, and I'm beginning to think that she actually is unfit and so is he. That's what I'm beginning to see. The child herself is displaying weird acts. Not only that she was twerking, because I don't think there's anything wrong with the child twerking, but she's also using profanity, which is definitely from the mother's side. But then you have a man that isn't socially equipped to be a father, and a lot about raising children. I'm not a mother, but at least I was raised. I know that you need to be social. You need to be able to play with friends and go out and have ballet classes. And if this is someone who's really concerned about how he looks, and I know that's not a lie, because I remember even on the show,
Keeping up with
the Kardashians, they used to talk a lot about how he refused to like even show up on the show because he was very conscious and he was honest about it. He even replied and said, well, his family grew up on this set and he has so much pressure from the social media.
I think
and that's why he doesn't want to come out. But do you think that that's enough for a child though? Like, would a child not need to go out despite the fact that you are overweight?
No, I get what you're saying, but the example of him not wanting to show up on TV on the reality show.
Yeah.
I think that is totally understandable.
Yeah. But for his child to be able to socialize is another thing.
I feel for Rob because I'm a huge fan. Well, I used to be a huge fan of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, and I can actually start Rob's story from the beginning to where he is right now. Rob, it will amaze you that in the midst of that influence and affluence his family seems to command and have, he has a very poor self-image about himself.
Yeah.
All right, so the weight thing started after, I'm trying to remember this is girl's friend name.
The girl on The Real Now.
On The Real Now, after she broke up with him.
Adrian.
Yeah, Adrian. That affected his esteem greatly. He went from like this to like this. He never recovered. I don't think he's recovered. Then sitting back, always at home, eating, getting fat. Now that became the biggest issue for him. Why at some point on the show, they were not showing him any longer. He couldn't keep up with it any longer. You know, but for Blac Chyna coming out to say because he suffers depression and he doesn't go out, and for that reason, he wouldn't be able to take care of the Dream. I pretty much don't agree with that. Because at the end of the day, kids, all you have to do, put kids in school, have somebody look after them properly.
Don't forget, there's a role of parents. You know there is, they already had the shared parenting system, right?
Yeah. Now they want sole custody.
Now it's sole custody. They are fighting for sole custody.
Now this
she
said something very pivotal.
She's saying that the child has to go out. The child has to mingle. And sometimes you as a parent, you have to show up. You cannot just say, oh, nanny, take the child.
Now, hold up. Rob did also say that was then, in a statement, that all of that happened because, yes, he did agree to the fact that he did suffer depression. He didn't want to be seen outside because he was dealing with a whole lot of personal issues.
He was or he is?
Well, he said he was.
You know,
so I wouldn't want to say because of that. Blac Chyna has a point there to say, you know what, he
well, then
take,
you can say the same thing for her, too, that she was then.
Then again,
everything comes to play.
Do you want to know my stance on this? I feel women own children. That's my honest stance about this, that children belong to women. But at the end of the day, look at what the Dream is beginning to do. She says she doesn't have a problem with the baby twerking. I do. You know, and then she's using profanity. The F word, cussing. Already the child is getting influenced. Who? The mother. So how much of a good influence is she going to be in the child's life?
For Rob now,
the only issue is he doesn't socialize, he doesn't go out.
That's the only issue. What you're arguing is bad influence and no influence. That's what you're arguing.
No, not necessarily. I don't think Rob will be no influence. At the end of the day, I mean, like I rightly said, the woman owns the child. He wants to go give dream to his Kardashian sisters.
That's what he wants to. That's his plan. To go give it to Khloe.
You can't say for sure, though.
Well, he keeps bringing Khloe into all the things. Khloe is the one speaking to.
But we'll never know until if he wins. So custody, listen,
you said
if
you've
we
been
win,
watching, hold you've been watching this guy for a long time. Let's try to look at it.
No, if I try to look at it, I can draw other lines. Scott is so much involved in his kid's life, as much as I feel. And what's her name?
Courtney
comes of like a very sad person. You know, Kurt does his best to be part of the kid's life. At some point, we're not talking about the Kardashians now, are we? Kurt really wanted to get married, but Courtney was not interested in the whole marriage thing, mm-hmm. you know. So again, if you say he's just going to drop Dream at the Kardashian, not necessarily true. He has access to his sister's or his mother's home. He can always be there.
Kardashian.
But I'm just saying at the end of the day, Dream is already getting influenced, whether we like it or not.
You don't think she's going to pick up things that are negative from the Kardashians as well?
What moral standard is working a bad thing? It's a given.
For a child that's just like playing around. She's not saying she wants to be a stripper. And even if she says she wants to be a stripper, what is wrong with
that? It is illegal practice. She's not of that age to make
exactly
that.
Exactly why twerking is also
a problem. What she's doing, it's observation.
You don't think she's going to copy the Kardashians and start painting her face or doing whatever they're doing?
But she's not going to stay with the Kardashians. She's going to be with her father if he gets her sole custody.
And they never leave the house because he's too bothered about taking pictures.
There's something you said I'm going to agree with, though. You say, you know, they're both bad influences.
Yeah.
So now it's going left to the court to decide who they feel
will
wield a better influence.
Give it to Chris. Chris is a good manager, a good mother.
Which is why Rob should have Dream, because she will definitely be passed on to Chris.
I think she should still have sole custody. The mother should, but then she should also be able to interact more with that family.
I think they should have shared custody.
Like they already have now. But now, Rob's concern is...
Because he's the one bringing up this whole issue.
Well, to be honest with you, he's bringing some heavy issues about the mother.
I've been an alcoholic.
Problems,
you know,
throwing knives at people. Like, it's a bit...
That's a big issue.
Yeah, it's a big issue.
We've come out to say it is not true.
Who the
sources and the documents?
He but when Black really China had come out
nothing.
Say it's true.
He really had
Black
nothing
China was
to
Ali,
back
was
it
Ali
up.
Two legally. Days
me,
old.
I have
Ali
seen the ending
old.
Of
this matter.
China's season, the reality show that
they had their own reality show.
I never kept up with that. She is mad aggressive. I'm not going to lie.
Exactly. Okay. I was just going to say, you were saying she was Ali 2 days old in Nigeria. She already wished that she caused trouble somewhere.
She's a fighter. Yeah.
And mom is even worse.
But he saw that before they, you know, came together and produced the lovely baby.
But I feel for Rob.
He's there with a whole lot.
I feel for China as well.
You know, I feel for Rob.
We feel for them. We have to move on with our feelings. Michael Jackson's younger son, Blanket, buys $2.6 million house in Katla, Basas, California, days after his 18th birthday. The home is located in one of the area's many gated communities, which is patrolled by guards 24/7. His new estate has almost 6,400 square feet of living space, complete with 6 bedrooms and 7.5 bedrooms.
You know, let me help people break it down for those who don't know how much that amount is in our naira. $2.6 As of Saturday, the dollar was 316 naira to the naira was 316 to the dollar. That's almost 1 billion naira, 936 million naira.
And like the blogs put it, that's his way of getting into adulthood.
This is it, man. We all get into adulthood differently.
This is such a great way to get into adulthood. When I was reading the story, I was just like, why did Michael Jackson give birth to me? That's what I was doing on the screen.
People would say, hey, he's a son to legendary pop icon. I mean, Michael Jackson's estate.
Motivational speakers, I will tell you, we won't.
But don't forget that he
has
his struggles as well.
Of course.
I don't mind struggling in a fancy house.
Let me not lie to you. We're all struggling.
I'm sorry, man.
Just sprinkle that nice house all over it. That'll be great.
You know, but again, it's 18. I mean, hey, it's young. That's an eligible age in America. And so I'm just hoping at the end of the day he's able to keep up with dates and. I hope he has a good head on his shoulders.
What I hope for him, really, with this house is that as beautiful as it is filled with love. warmth, real people, people actually love
how
him.
Many people
it's a big house. I wonder what he's going to do alone. He's just 18.
Away from drooling over the house and the fact that he has access to this kind of finance, I don't think he needs this kind of
it's
house.
18,
I'm sorry.
You know
I don't
mean?
Think so. I might be talking from the overly Nigerian perspective, but I don't think he needs it.
He will have his friends, his
girlfriends, so
his aunties.
This is what pushes them to party all weekend and then get into drugs and then get into trouble.
Well, I mean,
trouble.
He hasn't really had that history yet. And I'm not saying that he would. But like I said, I'm hoping that he has guidance. He must have had guidance to still be able to... At least I'm hoping that he has had guidance to make this type of decision.
Talking about him, where's Paris? Where's Paris? Nobody's hearing. I don't know where Paris is.
And that's a good thing. The fact that we're not hearing about these kids as much. It gives me hope. I think they have adult guidance and good guidance. So I'm hoping he fills his house with love and he grows into a fine man, does better in the places that his father couldn't, and, you know, lives his own life, really. Okay.
In case he needs someone to fill up the house, we can.
Hi. Hello. My name is Ifeoma.
Okay. It's time for a quick break. Well, when we return, there's definitely so much more to discuss.
Welcome to Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, where we bring you the biggest entertainment stories and, of course, analyze them for you.
You can have both parents and still end up as a useless child. At the scene every day.
Most times, I worry more about where I'm coming from and where I am now. Wow. And that determines my next step.
Why are you sounding like Alibaba?
Alibaba.
Now? Plus TV Africa, we're feeling good. No time to dull, everybody feeling all right.
Make music and people are still buying. Sometimes I look myself minimal IO.
Apala music is for mature minded people. I got DMs sometimes from Malawi, like, woo!
Sleeping early.
Sleeping early. Welcome back. This is still Tea Time on Plus TV Africa. If you get here or if you got here without them, you don't need them to get there. And this is coming from Naira Marley. Okay, I'll keep my opinions to myself and move over to the corporate Malian.
The only Malian.
That's what I'm going to say, right? I mean, Naira Marley can just never do wrong by me. You know what I mean? I'm just saying, it's a matter of personal opinion. And he couldn't have said it better. You know, sometimes I feel we get too modest trying to give people accolades that shouldn't be getting an accolade when it comes to our successes in life. And sometimes we actually forget the me factor. Knowing that at the end of the day, if you didn't make some moves, some people will not even believe in you. Like, in the life of me, while I'm grateful to all the platforms that have given me the opportunity to showcase my creativity and talent, but besides that, I mean, I can't point to any hand and say, you know, you grew me along the way, you helped me along the way, you trained me, you told me things to do. Nobody, you know, like, you learned the hard way, you learned on the job, you made your mistakes, you owned your L's, and then you moved on with it. And so to me, I totally agree with what he said. And at the end of the day, success, as they say, has so many friends. You begin to succeed, everybody wants to identify with him, we know him, he's ours. But the truth is, if I got here without you, I really don't need you.
Tell him.
So let's just stay where we are. I don't need you. Not that I hate you, but I go here without you, so I'm fine without you where I am right now.
Let's just
now.
Focus on where we're getting to, first of all. Where are we getting? Because
we're on Tea Time Farm.
Like,
Tea Time right here. So I'm fine.
Let's be clear where we have gotten. That's what I can say from this. Naira Marley can say that because he has gotten to Naira Marley. But I'm seeing some people who are like, honey, just calm down. You need network, you need people. You haven't really gotten there.
Don't
misunderstand Naira Marley. I'm sure there are people in his life that have helped him get to where he is now.
Of course.
So he is basically
saying those.
I understand what he's saying. Yeah. I'm saying us, the receiver. I'm not talking about, that's what I said. I started with Naira Marley. He knows what he's saying.
Not us, them, Marians.
I'm saying the fans should be careful with what he's saying. Because
and how they apply it.
Yes, because we haven't. You don't want to get too pompous with the idea that you're an island because
even Naira Marley isn't.
Exactly. So you need there is a platform that you need to.
You know that word is really overrated. That no man is an island on its own, because at the end of the day, if you have nothing to show people.
Value.
I'm the type. Exactly. No, nobody's going to come close to you. They associate because they feel there's value you have.
Yeah, well, at the same time,
if you have nobody will get close to.
Even you will not associate with a person who brings nothing to the table. Like,
definitely.
Absolutely nothing. So I think that's how the world works.
It does.
And
yeah.
If you want anyone to be able to groom you, think about you when something, an opportunity is coming up, then you have to have proven that you are worth the benefit of doubt.
Right.
At least that's the least anybody can give to you. So, no man is an island. I don't think it is exaggerated. I think it works.
It's over-exaggerated.
But you have to also...
Because you walk.
Yes.
Well, you have to work in your corner. You have to face the wall. Are you not going to interact with people?
You
are not going
to interact with people based on what value you bring into the table.
Yeah, but you have to bring it. The table isn't just you on it. It's with people.
No, at the beginning, the table is just you. At the beginning, it's the table. And how you want to set that table.
And then you have to choose the people that comes... Into
on
your
table,
you know. it's not your island.
But in his words, it's true. I know a lot of people, especially if you have a success story, you always find the people that have believed in you and the ones who didn't. And it's always the people, for me in my life, I feel like the ones who haven't are the ones I most expected to. Like I was thinking, this person would definitely have my back, but they don't. And they don't believe in my cause. So I'm going to remember that when I blow, because I haven't even started, guys. Don't come for me. So I'm even, you know, when I really blow, like I know the people I'm going to think about in my mind, like, oh, you were not there when I needed you. You were not there to, you know, either guide me in whatever way that is I was looking for support.
You're not
from
there to retweet my tweets.
Like my pictures. I'm a kid. But like, no, deeper support, really. So I understand where he's coming from. And it's good to remember that. I find that some people actually do forget it. I'm a people's person, like I always say, and I don't hold things dearly. And growing up, I remember I would like, forget that they have hurt me and then take them back in and then you get burnt again and again. So it's a good advice to remember that.
Are you a Pisces?
No, I'm an Aries.
Oh, you're an Aries. We're so close like that. I mean,
yeah.
But I mean, you know.
So yeah, it's good to remember. Just focus on the people that actually matter and sieve out the crowd.
And sometimes
I'm just
going
to say to people out there, where you have a platform of opportunity to help people, always try to listen to people. Try to hear them out and see what way you can actually contribute. It's not always financial. It could just be that listening ear. I know a lot of people, a lot of artists who have been torn down today. Mm. If I mention 1, 2, 3 names, you wouldn't believe they went through what they went through. But at the point they were trying to, you know what, I can do this. Timaya is one of those people. Mm. Timaya was not accepted.
It's part of their process.
Don't you get it?
And he's put all that.
So if Timaya should come out and say now, you know what, I mean, hey, if you were not there for me when I was going through my process.
And no hard feelings. I don't think everybody can help you. I don't think I can help everyone.
Critically.
I'm not going to believe in everybody. That's not true. So I think it's fine. Just know your circle. Know who's for you. Everyone has their own crowd. Like I know people say that all the time, like especially with content creation, like not everyone's gonna like your content, but you would find that target audience that just digs it. So even in real life, just do that and stick to that.
If you're like Omai, who is soft and forget, I think it is important to remember.
I don't forget.
And create a boundary.
Yeah.
I'm not saying
it's very important.
You need to be able to set the boundary to say, no, you're supposed to be here, not on this side.
Yeah, because what happens without Omai, if you don't set those boundaries, they always feel they can do it again and again.
Like, I felt like I was getting bitten, like I was learning the same story over and over. So at some point, you have to put those boundaries in there. And the same thing goes back to even Michael Jackson's story where you need people around you. Michael Jackson's story where you need people around you that really have got your back.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's how I end up this tea time, right? Thank you for watching. And remember, you can watch this conversation by visiting our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. You can also watch Tea Time on Also TV and in London on Ben Television. My thank you, as always, will go to my co-anchors, Benny Ack and Ife Omai, and the entire production team. Thank you for watching. My name is Elsie Godwin. Have yourselves a great day.